wing. There's no flying in already down there.
Yeah, somewhere. I see it.
Like another one coming down too.
Vermont this morning. He just arrived a few minutes ago and he said that the visibility out here is really lousy. So we've just got to bear with him and give everybody a chance to get in here. We've been fighting the weather all summer long. This is the second time we've been up to Keene this year. The last time, unfortunately, we did get rained out. And if you look to the rear of the ramp area,
we've got some airfare still in the air. On the ground here today. Direct Stead from Manchester, New Hampshire. He's the president of Stead Aviation. He brought in at deHavilland DH-115 Empire. It's the English jet fighter that is parked down there next to the H-10. That particular jet fighter was built in 1958. However, the initial design was made in 1944. As I said, it's an English jet fighter. On the ground at the 790, from the center of the field, coming up on the intersection. Very interesting home-built airplane. The C-141 is directly overhead. Within the last 2 years, the C-141 was modified. The fuselage was stretched, I believe, about 8 feet. And it is an in-air refueling capability, something that it didn't have in the past. Extended the life of this aircraft probably into the year 2000. The Lockheed C-141 Starlifter.
C-141 Lockheed Starlifter. It's a transport aircraft. I believe this one is out of Dover, Delaware.
41 Starlifter from McGuire Air Force Base. The aircraft is a four-engine, and I believe there are turbo fans on this airplane. And as I said, the aircraft commander is a native
approaching.
Top speed on these airplanes is in the vicinity of 200 miles an hour. They have retractable gear. They're all metal airplanes with fabric control surfaces, which are the aileron, rudder, and elevator. Our jumpers are getting ready here. They're going to be climbing aboard the aircraft very shortly.
You can see how easily Sam spun that engine over and got it started. Well, incidentally, my name is Al Ronco. I'm the director and narrator for Northeast Air Shows. And in the program today, there's a small short story of Northeast Air Shows and how we got started. And the aircraft that we do have available to us for air show flying. We've been in business for about 8 or 9 years. The 31st of this month will be in Sanford, Maine, at the Sanford Airport. September 7th is Southbridge, Massachusetts. September 14th is Oneonta, New York. September 21st is Columbia County, New York. Down in Hudson, New York, just south of Albany. And the 28th of September, we plan on being in Torrington, Connecticut for an air show down there. We have rather a busy schedule. Who knows to pull flags this aircraft from the back seat? I'd say that was about a 1940 deHavilland Tiger bomb.
Tiger moth, horse moth, and gypsy moth.
miles an hour. Can you imagine flying cross country in one of these things? You could retire by the time you got there. Four-cylinder inverted engine. That means the engine's upside down in the airplane. See him climbing for a little bit of altitude out there. He's going to drop that ribbon out of the aircraft. See how many times he can cut it before it hits the ground. The ribbon. This guy is flying his airplane, no spring chicken. If you had seen him walking down the ramp, he was an elderly gentleman. He's been flying for a long, long time. As I said, on the weekends, he flies at the Rhinebeck Aerodrome, the World War I Fighter Flying Museum down there in Rhinebeck, New York. Okay, I've got it in sight. It's right over the old terminal. There goes the first cut, I believe. Either that or he missed it. That's a roll of toilet paper that he's thrown out. There, he just got the top part of it. He assured me that it was a new roll. Radius on this airplane. It's quite maneuverable for the size of the airplane. It's a very slow airplane. He's lost sight of that ribbon, but they say he's got another roll. Thank you.
All right.
and he comes down from the red.